Welcome back. In this episode, we're going to be talking about loops. Now, loops are going to let you execute code over and over again, and this is where a lot of the power of programming lies, in letting you do small tasks again and again. Now, the first kind of loop that I'm going to talk about are while loops. And while loops will execute as long as whatever condition you set remains true. Now, you have to be a little bit careful with these, because it's easy to create an infinite loop. Say, I equals 0, and while I is less than 10, print f I is not yet 10. So then we have to increment I. If I doesn't change, you're going to get an infinite loop. So I equals I plus 1. This might look a little strange to you, but this is just the same as saving strings back on top of themselves. It's a little more common because I equals I plus 1 is such a common thing to do in coding. You can actually use a shorthand for it, which is I plus or equal 1. We'll go ahead and run this code. I'll go ahead and do Python 08 loops 1 while. I'll run this, and you can see that it just says 0 is not yet 10, 1 is not yet 10, so on and so forth, up to 9 is not yet 10. You can see it doesn't actually get to 10. And down here, it just does the same thing over again. Now, I do want to show you something really quickly. Let's go back here, and let's actually forget to increment I. So what we have here is going to be an infinite loop. And I'll run this just again, and you can see that it's going to print this over and over and over again. You can stop this using Control C on your computer. And this will just stop the program from running. This is a useful thing to know how to do. I'm going to change this back just so I don't accidentally do that again. And let's go to the next piece of code. Another very useful type of loop is a for loop. Now, these are less dangerous than while loops because they don't have this problem of not incrementing. So, excuse me, if I want to do the exact same thing, print up to but not including 10, I can use the range function. This creates an iterator, which is just something that iterates. So for I in range 10, print I is not yet 10. You can also specify the number that you want to start at. So for I in range 2, 10, we'll just start at 2. You can also, inside these for loops, change I, but note that this will not change how I is actually incrementing. So for I in range 10, print 3, I is not yet 10, I'm going to add 10 to I every single loop, and then just show you what it looks like. We'll go ahead and run this. We'll say loops 2 what did I call this? 4.py. We can say, OK, what we've done is first we just ran this loop. This looks exactly the same as the thing we just looked at. Then we're going to do it again, except we're going to start at 2. Then what we want to do is we're going to say this 3, 0 is not yet 10, added 10 and now have 10. 1 is not yet 10, 11, and so on and so forth. So you can see that unlike the while loop, where the changing of I actually affects the logic of the loop, this I gets reset to whatever that range iterator had set it at every time the loop reruns. Now, you can also use these for iterators, or for loops, while looking at strings or lists. So you can iterate through a lot of different kinds of objects. So my list equals A, B, C, D, E, and my string equals chug a lug. And what I'm going to do then is I'm going to say for item in my list, colon, tab, print item. Now, that item variable, I am creating myself. You can change this to anything that you want, and it wouldn't affect the code as long as you change it both here and here. So I'm just going to iterate through each item in my list, and then I'll also iterate through each character in a string. So for char in my string, I'm just going to change this to char yay and char yay to show you that these are just variables that I have come up with that I am then using inside of this loop. I'll go ahead and run this. Let's see, 2, 4, B. Then I'll say, OK, A, B, C, D, E, It's printing each of these items in this loop, and it's also printing all of the individual characters in chug-a-lug. So we can use these loops to do some very interesting and complicated things. Now, we can also stack loops on top of each other, and we can insert if statements inside loops. We can just keep indenting to our heart's content. So you can nest code blocks like loops and Boolean statements to create more complex logic. So if my list equals A, B, C, D, E, I can then go through every item in this list and say if item equals C, print item. I'll just run this really quickly. Python 09, and I'll see it only prints out C because that's the only character that matches my Boolean statement. The last thing I want to talk really quickly about in this episode are files. This is going to be a very important thing for the sake of the Hacking the Humanities course, because we'll often want to load information from a text file. To do this, it's quite simple. Reading and writing is something we're going to do a lot of in Python. And I'm going to start by showing you how to write to file. But I want you to know that you should be very careful with this. Whenever you write files, if the file exists already, it will delete what already exists and overwrite it, okay? If it doesn't exist yet, it'll create a new file for you, which is great. But it won't check if you want this deleted or not. So be a little careful with this. The other thing to know is when you create a file object, it's going to open an object in memory, and you're going to want to close it also. So here, I have a variable that I'm calling writeFile, and inside of it, I'm going to say open. And inside this open call, I'm going to say newfile.txt is a string. That's the name of the file that I want to save, comma, and then a W. This is the mode that I am opening this file in this case, write. And the encoding equals UTF-8. Now, this is just a character encoding. You'll need to set this if you're on a Windows machine. If you're on a Mac or Linux, you can actually ignore this. And then I'm just going to write writing to file. And then I'm going to do writefile.close. Now, alternatively, you can use what's known as a context manager, and this will close the object for you. And this is considered the more Pythonic way of opening a file. So with open newfile.txt, write, encoding equals UTF-8, so all of that's the same, as writefile. So here we're using an alias for this open object, and it's just the variable name writefile. And here I'm just going to say writefile.write, writing to file. Reading from file uses the read file. And this is a lot safer because it's not going to delete anything. You're just going to get an error if the file doesn't exist. And here you just need to use the R flag instead of the W flag. So contents equals, so you'll open the file object. Then to turn it into a string, you need to use .read. Here with this highlighting, you can see that this read file is a text IO wrapper. If I want it to be a string, I need to use .read. And then I'm going to close the file. And I'll go ahead and print the contents so we can see what it is. Sometimes you'll want to write something to a file without deleting it first. In this case, you'll use the append flag, which is just an A. And here, I'm just going to open up that same file and write more to file and afile.close. So let's go ahead and go back over to our terminal. I'm going to clear this off, and I'm going to list our files. And notice that I'm saving this as newfile.txt. And you can see that this doesn't exist inside our folder yet. But once I run the code, so Python 10 files, I'll run that. And it says writing to file, because remember, I wrote it to file, then I reopened it and printed it out. But now, if we just do ls again, we can see that there's now a newfile.tx file here. And if we go into our Visual Studio Code and we scroll down, we can see that, hey, this both exists and it appended that extra string to it. So this is a very useful thing if you want to save the results of the script that you're running to file so you can use it later. And it's useful for reading in data from text, which we'll see in a little bit. So thanks for watching, and in the next episode, we're going to start talking about dictionaries. Thank you for joining us.